What's up, River Music Team? There's so much going on this fall that I just couldn't write an email to you. I wanted to look you in the eye, so to speak, and tell you about what's happening. There's a lot of important changes that are happening this fall, so pay attention to this video, and I want to share with you how our ministry is going to be even more exciting and easier to manage this fall with some of the enhancements that we're bringing. So, let's get right into it. The first thing, which you probably already know, is that we're going to 3 experiences starting October 2nd. Now, what does that mean for the music team? Primarily, it means that we're going to try to rehearse on Saturday afternoons from 3:30 to 5:30 right in the auditorium, right in the pack, so we can set up, do the sound check on Saturday, and rehearse in real field conditions. Can't count the number of times we've been in rehearsal at the warehouse, right? We've said, well, we're just going to have to wait till Sunday to see how that really sounds because the sound changes so much. Well, in order to accomplish what we need to accomplish, and also to have 3 experiences on Sunday, which the first one starts at 9 a.m., we're really going to need to be in the auditorium for our rehearsal. So I am excited about this, but I'm also a little bit nervous about it. There are some of us that gig around. Some of us are members of bands, and it may be that this 3:30 to 5:30 time slot is not going to work as well as the earlier one. But we're going to try it, and we're going to see how it goes. Now, the fallback position is to have a rehearsal at 9 at the warehouse, and we may have to do that from time to time. The downside of that is that we'll have to come in even earlier on a Sunday morning because that first experience is at 9 to make sure that we're providing excellent music each Sunday. So let's go ahead and try, and we're going to start this October 1st. We're going to have a 3:30 to 5:30 rehearsal right in the auditorium. Wanted you to know that was coming up. Here's something really exciting that we've been trying to do for 2 years now, and we're finally getting it. It is a web-based, an internet-based scheduling center. It's called Worship Planning Center, and it really just organizes everything from music scheduling, text scheduling, drama scheduling. It's all in there, and it's easy-to-use web-based application. So this is going to take the place of the music blog, and we're going to be phasing this in October. Now, with this email that you got this video from, you'll see some tutorial videos about Worship Planning Center, and I highly, highly encourage you to take a look at those after you're done watching this or sometime this week, because it's easy to use, but you're going to want to know how to do it. Everyone is going to be invited to be a part of the Worship Planning software, and then once you're invited, you log in. You have your own screen name and password, so it's very secure. And it's really easy to say yes or no to scheduling and give reasons why you can or can't do it. You can also block out dates ahead of time on the calendar that you know you can't serve, and that's going to be really helpful for us. All of the MP3s and the PDF files of the charts are going to be on the Worship Planning Center, so everything is going to be in one place, and there's even a media player there so that you can play them right there when you log on. One cool thing is that this works on all platforms and all devices. So if you have an iPhone or you have an iPad or an Android phone, there's going to be an app for it. And you can even, if you have an iPad, use the charts right there in Worship Planning Center with the app. And on Sunday, have them right there to play as you serve. So really excited about this change. We're going to be phasing it in October. Definitely look at the tutorial videos. And I think you'll be really excited about how streamlined this is going to make the process. Well, because we're moving to this software, I need to let you know that we're making a change in our scheduler. Now, Sandy Jenkin has been our scheduler for a long, long time. But what we're going to do is we're going to move the scheduling to a centralized location. And Kim, our new creative arts assistant, who is at the church on Tuesday and we have a lot of interaction with during the week, is actually going to be administrating the Worship Planning Center software and making sure that all the scheduling takes place. So please welcome Kim when you have an interaction with her. And when you get a moment, thank Sandy. I mean, Sandy has been great. So many years scheduling for us with a smile and with a great attitude. We wouldn't be where we are today without Sandy. And so please thank her for the team, for yourself, and for me for the great job that she has done over the years. Now, I can't talk too much about this next thing, but I need to let you know that there's going to be some changes in the way we audition and recruit people in the future. We're going to be bringing the creative arts teams together and doing it as a group. And we have some real exciting initiatives that are coming. We're still in the planning stages of them, but I wanted to let you know that we're committed to get bringing more people on the team and just being even more excellent at what we do, not just on the music team, but all the creative arts teams. So excited to unwrap that in the future. Stay tuned. There's more on that to come. Now, finally, I just want to say that, you know, most of you have been hearing from me that the music team commitment is a once-a-month commitment, and we've talked about that now for a couple of years. And I want to reiterate that that really is the commitment for the music team. If you're a member of the music team, it's your responsibility to make sure that you're serving once a month. If we all serve once a month, then together we provide excellent and creative, inspiring music every Sunday. When one of us drops off that commitment, the whole team suffers. Everything suffers. So I want to thank you for making that commitment and encourage you to continue to do that. In fact, if you can't make a date that we ask you for, your first thought should be, okay, but what other Sunday can I serve? Because I need to make sure that I'm on that stage once a month. I know many of you do that. Thank you so much. Let's make sure that we're all doing that so we can provide great music every week. Now, I'm aware that I'm talking to some of us that are on the music team because you're hired in, or you might be serving from another church. You attend another church, but you also serve on our music team. And I know that it would be difficult for me to ask you to commit to a once-a-month schedule, but I want to challenge you to think about stepping up to that anyway, so that as a team we can be strong. There may even be some that are being hired in right now that are feeling that maybe their next step is to turn that hire into a volunteer status and begin to volunteer on the team to give something back to God for all the talent that He's given you. I'm not asking directly anyone to do that. I'm just putting it out there just in case God is speaking to someone and saying, you know what, I appreciate the opportunities at the River, and I think I want to give something back to God and turn that into a volunteer opportunity. So I'm just putting that out there just in case. Hey, you know what? Thanks for listening to me. I'm really excited about the fall. Let's do this together. Let's do this as a team. You know, I'm working hard to make sure that we have a balanced approach to scheduling and participation in our songs and in our music, and to make sure that no one feels slighted or left out. At the same time, I'm trying to raise the bar on some of our emerging leaders and singers, band members. And so as we go through that process, there's bound to be some bumps in the road. I just want to assure you that I'm working hard to make sure that there's a fairness in how we schedule and how we're doing things, and we're continuing to work that out. So thanks for giving me grace on that as we make our team even stronger than it already is. Hey, thanks so much for serving. Love you guys. I'm gonna see you soon. Check out those links to the Worship Planning Center, and I'm looking forward to some great ministry this fall.